Hey you guys, it's Isabella Gomez from One Day at a Time, and I'm here today at Netflix. We are meeting up with Dulce Candy, who is a phenomenal YouTuber, and we're gonna be talking about makeup and season two and her life, and it's gonna be incredible.
Hi Isabella.
Hi. How are you?
Good, so good to see you.
So good to finally meet you.
Yes, likewise.
Glam makeup for events, amazing, I love it. But in my real life, I would say I have makeup on maybe 40, 30% of the time.
Really?
Yeah.
I remember being 18 years old, and for me, makeup was like a mask, because I was very self-conscious about myself. And when I joined the military and I was stripped away from wearing makeup, it was a life-changing thing for me and it made me see makeup differently.
There's so many conflicting opinions about it. And just like any other art, there's people that are offended by it and think you're hiding and like we were saying, like a mask.
Being a mom, I have a 7-year-old and going to school with like a full face of glam, I honestly feel a little bit self-conscious because I feel like I'm being judged for being maybe a little too put together or wearing too much makeup.
This is really cool as an art and as a thing I do for fun, but I never want to rely on it to feel beautiful. Yeah.
And that's why I really enjoy one of the episodes where your abuelita came in with her little caboodle trying to do your makeup in the middle of the night. Oh, yeah.
We actually talk about it in season two. Yeah. We talk about how I'm a very light-skinned Latina and I could pass for American. Because I've had conversations with other Latinas that are a little darker that look more Latina, whatever that means, because we look like everything.
See, that's another issue too right there.
But now that people know I'm Latina and I'm in a Latina show and I use that platform, it's cool because I get to use it for good.
I immigrated in 1984. Nice. I was 6, so I was a little girl. And I remember the whole journey, jumping fences, crossing rivers, sleeping in dingy hotels and garages. The only challenge that I feel like that I have now is just my English. I feel like English is such a hard language to learn.
What?
So I'm trying to master English and I'm trying to master my Spanish.
But you speak English perfectly.
Thank you. No, but sometimes, <You're> like, thank you very much, actually. I personally can relate to your TV mom, Penelope, quite a lot, actually, because I'm also a female veteran.
Wait, are you still on hold with the VA?
No. I got right through.
You know, she's dealing with PTSD, which is something that, you know, after I came back from Iraq, I suffered from a mild case of it.
Norman Lear, who's our executive producer, is a veteran, and he's the one that wanted Penelope to be a veteran because of that. There's no representation for you guys in media. So then it's that whole thing of like, do I reach out? Do I get professional help? Is this a real thing? Because it's never talked about and it gets to be taboo. Yeah.
Mentira! But therapy is for the locals. I told you that you would lose your mind taking those antiperspirants.
Well, not only for being Latinx, but also LGBTQ, my character's LGBTQ.
Oh, yes.
There's so many people that are like, I've never seen myself represented anywhere in any sort of media, whether it's YouTube or TV or movies, and now they're starting to see themselves, and it's such a beautiful thing to be a part of.
No, I really commend you for that because your character is literally changing people's lives, you know, changing the way that people feel and how they come out to their parents and feeling comfortable with who they are, which is, I just got goosebumps. I got goosebumps.
I remember my first red carpet. I literally could not do it. I didn't want to do it. And the publicists were like, you need the exposure. It's for the show, just a picture with the cast. And I was like, I don't want to be in front of that camera.
Yeah.
And I realized I had like, you know, certain confidence issues and I realized why and I worked on that. And now, I mean, the carpet's still intimidating, but it's so much more fun now. It's been interesting to grow as a person through my characters.
Yeah.